handful of seeds. 300,000 pounds of tomatoes to be. Tiny tomato plants, babies, each tenderly planted in its own container. A month later, healthy, growing adolescents. The result of carefully controlled temperature, enough sunlight, and ample attention. Modern commercial greenhouse operators have to think big. It takes a lot of power and preparation. A blanket of live steam heats the soil to 180 degrees Fahrenheit, disinfesting. Absolutely necessary for profitable crop production. Water, about 200,000 gallons per acre, washing the soil, cleansing it of unwanted salt, people call it leaching. Cradled and ready. And finally, the beginning. Enough sunlight and plenty of steam heat. Two vital ingredients. But not too much. Control, that's the key. Ventilation, precise. Just the right climate and balance to perfection, automatically. Electricity, there can be no automation, no control, no heat or ventilation. The insurance against power failure, diesel electric generators on constant standby. A big investment, possibly never used. 30 heatless minutes in zero weather can devastate a fragile greenhouse crop. These tomato plants would never get off the ground by themselves. The greenhouse vegetable industry is a story with more than one plot. Here's a house full of cucumbers. The routine is the same. Prepare the soil, plant, keep it warm, and hope for sunlight. And just as important, The human touch. A grower who cares. It never rains in a greenhouse, it pours. And water is more than a drink for thirsty plants. Vital nutrients are often added to this water supply, food and drink in one operation. Yes, we worry. High yields depend on good fruit set, or, more scientifically, effective pollination. Honeybees left unemployed by a cold winter season are the perfect answer. And it's easy, at least for the grower. Rent a hive of bees and turn them loose on a house full of cucumber plants. There may be more than 60,000 blooms to visit every day in a house this size. But bees won't work on tomatoes. The flowers are different. Mechanical buzzers are used to shake the pollen loose from the stamens in every bloom. Each single grain of pollen landing on the stigma and traveling down the style to the ovary creates one seed in the developing tomato. And there's an exciting new development on the cucumber scene. No bees, no buzzers, no pollination, and no seeds. Long, seedless cucumbers are exactly that, long and seedless. This delicious variety has become a consumer favorite. Here's a crop of tomatoes well on the way. Soon be time to pick. In the meantime, there's work to be done. Daily checks for disease or insects, keep them warm, watered, trained, and trimmed. And sunlight? Well, that's nature's job. Days are getting longer now, warmer too. The plants will soon be heavy with this year's crop. Many hands are always needed at harvest. Thank you. Things are really moving now, and for the next 3 or 4 months. Every morning, pick the crop, load the truck, get that product on its way to market, fresh off the vine, and freshness really does count. Most growers in the Leamington area take crops to a central packing house. There are several, very busy. These tomatoes were picked this way on purpose, just a tinge to a blush of pink. From here to market, they'll ripen naturally and reach their destination at the peak of perfection. Inside, they are sorted, then graded for size, weight, color, and quality. Fast work and well done. Cucumbers, the whole royal family. Prince, queen, king. Marketing, where, when, and how much? The Ontario Greenhouse Vegetable Producers Marketing Board looks after the details. Graded, packaged, and sold. Signed, sealed, and on the way. There's more than one way to sell a greenhouse tomato or cucumber. Some greenhouse operations are a family affair, everything under one roof. Plant, propagate, grow, and grade. Near large cities like Toronto, most growers make their own sales, governed only by prices set by the marketing board. Toronto Dawn, a marketing mecca for hundreds of greenhouse producers. First come, first served. Competition? Fierce, but friendly. Thank you.
Post 129 is our better soldier.
The one that's never told.
Cancel the order. Hands next, let's go. Come on, go.
They're blue boots there. It's going to be blue boots. Stop for $7.
That's one. Okay.
Just a marketplace, it's a way of life. Yeah, it's a good feeling to close a deal. But it takes more than sales savvy and a green thumb to keep this greenhouse industry alive and well. Science, never-ending research, looking for new varieties, higher yields, gaining control of disease, insects, improving the good while looking for something better. Patient, dedicated people, the innovators behind the inside story. And there's more. During the off-season, before production of tomatoes and cucumbers, many growers plant short-term filler crops like butterhead or leaf lettuce, very perishable. But then, nearly everything in this business is perishable. Even plastic and glass houses. There are no summer vacations for greenhouse men with housework. And so it goes and grows. From the greenhouse capital, Leamington, in the sun parlor of Ontario, around the Golden Horseshoe, to Toronto and north to the highly productive Bradford Marsh. More than 16 million square feet of food under glass. One of the most challenging and productive enterprises in Ontario's modern agriculture. The inside story.
I don't believe I'll eat the whole thing.